We would call the meeting to order at 1:03.
Review of the minutes of the January, excuse me, 22nd meeting.
Accept the minutes of the January 22nd meeting.
A second?
Excellent.
In the review of business from last month, one of the items from the January 22nd meeting was a GPS unit for the van, which is temporarily tabled. It was discussed at the last Friends of the Newbury Council on Aging meeting in February. It's not at the moment a priority. So we're leaving that for a time that may become more of an issue.
It's going to change?
They don't have a great need for a GPS unit at the moment. You know, it's standalone, the van doesn't come with that capability. It didn't come with the 2016 van. The volunteer on the van, the property tax volunteer on the van, has a smartphone, and she's able to act as a co-pilot.
Okay.
So for the time being, it's not a problem. At the January 22nd meeting, a new business item was getting Newbury residents to the First Parish Church food pantry on Friday afternoons, which is still open for discussion, still trying to put all of these details together. We have spoken about a phone, use of a phone for a contact person on Friday afternoon, since the Council on Aging is closed. So that's still under discussion. And also had a few other people weigh in, other interested parties, about having volunteers drive people. Certainly an option. Just had a conversation this morning, as a matter of fact. So hope to, with the May-June newsletter, put out the message that we're interested in helping people get to the food pantry, and ask people to call the Council on Aging to let us know that they'd like to go so we can really see how much interest there might actually be.
I did some digging around and asking questions, and the feedback that I got that it was the time of day.
It's been part of our conversation here is having a driver for the, certainly for the winter months, for the logistics of a driver. They'll be finishing in the dark since the food pantry is 3 to 5 o'clock on Fridays. So there's that little
short time frame for however amount of actual work it's going to be, especially for folks who are going to be driving from, or when you rise from the coverage area.
Exactly, and that was, you know, part of the conversation this morning. It was a woman who called this morning who offered to drive people from Byfield, which is wonderful. And we talked about the fact that we'll need to offer rides to anyone, anywhere in Newbury, Byfield, Plum Island. Again, the coverage area is more broad than some of our neighboring towns who pick up from their senior housing or public senior housing communities. So we would be opening it up to everybody.
I think it was not, it was the elderly that I talked to, they're kind of in for the day by that time.
Right, which is perhaps explains why we haven't had a lot of interest. It's been certainly been discussed on the van with people who ride the van regularly. And there's one person, possibly two, of the regular participants on the van who have expressed an interest, but not a driving, you know, I'd really like to go this week interest.
In typing the minutes, the figure of how many people come, is that
The numbers, that was, I think, when we met, I had just spoken with the woman who organizes it, and that's a pretty remarkable.
I think it would be so overwhelming for senior people to go in there not knowing anything about it, if this, I haven't been there, so I don't know how big it is, but if you have 100 minutes.
137 they had it one, you know, one Friday afternoon.
And it's in 2 hours.
It's 2 hours, you know, because they have a time frame, because there's either a preschooler or a nursery school in the church, so they have that window of time from, I think, 12 or 1 o'clock when they can get in to set up the food pantry. So they can't do it earlier in the day. So we'd actually inquired about that, too. We do it earlier, we do it Monday through Thursday, a little earlier in the day, but it's, at the moment, it's not an option.
I know we're lucky to have it, and the volunteers that do it, it's wonderful.
It is.
And everything comes perfect for everyone else.
Right, and, you know, serving 85 or 100 or more people every Friday
is
incredible.
And they bring everything or help bring things to the car, and that's why we need the volunteers to get the things out of the car.
Exactly, and that was another question, and in whatever way we word this for the next newsletter, that's been brought up also, and I think we discussed it too, having people call and put in an order, mm-hmm. and then perhaps we have the van pick up the orders and just drop them off, they would put an order together. They've offered that, which is lovely.
Do they list what they have so that people can, or how does that work?
I
think that changes some. Again, I think, you know,
it's
everything's
all,
perfect.
Donated, but, so how do they know that?
Right. You know, if someone could say, you know, I'd like chicken, but I'll take beef if chicken's not available, I don't know what that looks like. They do have quite a few volunteers.
We should go look at it.
It's a good idea. A little field trip on a Friday.
Yeah. Of just so we can intelligently talk about it.
Exactly.
I think we're willing to do that. That is a good idea, just to really see what the lay of things is. They've offered, they have enough volunteers to, as you pointed out, Joyce, help people shop and then help them get it to the van.
That's amazing.
Well, it is. And then it would be, obviously, incumbent upon us to get that off the van, and, you know, and there's no limit,
this
so they can, in theory, get quite a bit of food.
And need to be able to have this boost in the grocery store without having to pay for it.
With everything, protein, dairy, produce, know, it's not just limited to non-perishables. So, all right, perhaps we can pick a mall Friday that might work.
Sure.
Check it out. And there will be more discussion by then about what makes some logical sense for the town as far as a contact person, if that's the route we decide to go. Even, I think, even if the Council on Aging van is just picking up orders and delivering them, it'd still be nice to have that contact person and a helper, volunteer to help on the van. We will need, I'm looking at volunteer needs, we will need a volunteer to help on Fridays with the van if that's the route we decide to go. I may have mentioned that the volunteer on the grocery trips, library trips, and field trips would like to be a backup volunteer as opposed to a primary volunteer. She's wonderful. We are very fortunate to have her for a number of reasons she'd like to be backed up instead of counted on every trip.
It's always nice to have a backup.
So, oh, yeah, absolutely. It is a good idea. So we'll probably post that in the next newsletter. And we can put that in the, on the town website. I think I passed out the expenditures since the January 22nd meeting. Anything particularly, we have the regular bills that show up pretty consistently.
Is that daily news for ads?
No, that's we have a subscription, which does include, and it's actually surprising how many people pick up the paper when they come in. It includes a digital subscription, which I don't know if I use. We did get two sets of speakers and computers when the floors were cleaned last summer. We had to move a lot, move the computers, and it became apparent that two sets were not functioning, so two sets. And the last expenditure, we still do monthly birthday cards, and some months have quite a few birthdays, so we needed a new supply.
When do you have your budget in?
The budget was presented in February, January, I think. And we'll do that for the next meeting. So you can see it. That'll be the budget for fiscal 18.
Does it have to be reviewed?
It has to be reviewed. So there will be a meeting at some point.
So you don't have
the administrator and the accountant. Annual report, the COA annual report for fiscal 16 was just presented. Just last week. The report to be printed for the April, I'm not remembering the date of the town meeting. On Tuesday, the end of April.
I think it's the 24th.
I think it is.
That when we fix the signs.
I think it is the 24th. far as outreach, which we have discussed previously, the outreach case manager, as was noted in these minutes, on January 22nd, is working out there nicely. And we just discussed this morning, continuing to review protocol and how the outreach department functions. Just doing an update, streamlining. We have had a little bit of an increase in outreach requests in just the last month.
Year to date, what is it like? Is it, has it increased since 2017 this time?
That would be an interesting question as to whether there's some seasonal impact.
Mm-hmm.
I'll have to take a look at that and see. This winter, naturally, we've had some issues with the storms lately.
Did we ever get a job description of what's expected of the outreach person? We do have that.
We do have that.
Do we have it, or do you have it?
I have it. You know, we have a file of all of the job descriptions.
Okay.
And as a matter of fact, that we were discussing that this morning for outreach to do a little review of some of the volunteer categories that fall under outreach, like a friendly visitor, telephone reassurance calls that falls under the category of outreach. Doing just a refreshing of it, because there have been descriptions of those positions for a long time, just doing a review as things change and evolve. Again, I'd have to go back and look at the records for requests to meet with the SHINE counselor with Medicare questions. But since the turn of the year, folks who are retiring, residents who are retiring, who just want to do some pre-planning as they get closer to retirement. So, SHINE is serving health information needs of everyone, is that it?
I think so.
And we have a certified SHINE counselor who is pretty specifically Medicare. I can speak to that too.
Yeah, primarily they look at Medicare coverage and then the Part B coverage to make sure that they're on the right plan as far as the medications, what's going to be more cost effective for them, making sure that any of their co-payments, they can actually afford them. They go through, they have access to all of the Part B plans, and they can kind of narrow down consumer choices. So instead of looking at 500 of them, they're looking at 10 of them.
They can be mind-boggling.
Yes,
for sure.
But still allowing that consumer to actually choose whatever they want to as far as their best options.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, it's incredibly helpful. And normally during open enrollment period from November and October into early December, the SHINE counselor comes once a week, but throughout the rest of the year, it's every 2 weeks. Sometimes it's not enough interest, but we've had consistent interest since the beginning of January. So every 2 weeks, then we had a Thursday snowstorm, so that pushed things in. But consistent interest, so with at least usually three appointments twice a month.
Any isolated handouts for that, or is it all like when you do the newsletter, the SHINE program is described?
We'll do a little description in the newsletter.
Okay.
There is a brochure, a program brochure.
Oh, there is?
You know, our contact with the Greater Shine program is through Elder Services of the Merrimack Valley.
Mm-hmm.
As Chaz was saying, people generally appreciate having someone help navigate it because it is so complex
mm-hmm.
and so many options, so confusing.
Mm-hmm.
So it's wonderful. Bring your folder of everything, all your prescriptions, everything, and they'll go through line by line, which is great. He can't ever leave. He needs to stay here. Does anyone have any questions? Other questions about anything?
Have we had any residents who are still struggling with power or from the weather?
Any issues? Mm-hmm. I did. There was a resident who, so many residents, not this past week, but the week previous to that, second nor'easter, where there was so much of Newbury without power, by Phil and Fulham. Our residents' family were concerned, couldn't get in touch with her. So I ended up sending an email to the police department and they did a wellness check, which is great. That was an interesting, challenging situation with a couple of warming stations, which were open during that particular storm. Pitta Hall and Salvation Army, but no particularly deputy, from my perspective, but not a deputy.
I remember one time, I don't know how many years ago, but the Newbury School was set up as an emergency.
And I'd inquired about that before one of the storms, I think the first nor'easter, and there weren't plans to do that at that particular point for that particular storm. And I think that's always an option.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what degree the situation has to reach.
It'd be interesting to find out because I had some elderly asking me if it got to the point where they couldn't stay, where could they go? And I know in the past, if it's, I think it's the civil defense person who called and said, okay, if you have any elderly that need to be, need a cart, was wrong, or
mm-hmm.
you have such and such set up. But,
I don't know that it's
I didn't have
well
any answers for him this
anymore.
Time. I just had heard that Pitta Hall was available. But that was the only one I heard.
And that was
community
notification.
Once the storm started, it would have been hard to get
that. That was the problem. It started
the island, they would shut down the roads.
Oh, right, yeah. Yeah, so that's really not a dependable place.
No.
For people coming in.
Right.
People already here.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah,
realize,
people
yeah.
on the island, that would be possible.
Yeah.
They can't sleep at Pitta Hall. So that was really just a warming.
No, it's a warming, and there's a kitchen, and TV, and a generator that has all of the facilities.
Mm-hmm. It's nice to have.
There'd be no TV, though, because the cable would be down
right.
with the electricity.
Right.
You get a generator going, and whatever.
Share of lights and meat, yeah, at least.
Mm-hmm.
Potential for food.
Right.
Along the Byfield, we have the, this is just for the residents at Oak Ridge and Paper Hill, but we have generators that generate for the community room. So they're able to go in and recharge their phones.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's great.
They can have the warmth and they can make a pot of coffee.
Mm-hmm.
And,
is that in
that's
both
nice
of them?
Time?
Yes.
Oh, that's really
yeah.
nice.
That is nice.
Yeah.
That's nice.
And some people did stay overnight.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't. We don't have any cots, but
fall asleep in a chair.
In a chair,
yeah.
sure.
Sure. It's nice to have them. I don't know that Newbury Village has that. You would know, right? So I thought, again, in the, it'll be late, but in the May and June newsletter, and we'll just have to refresh this from time to time, about helping family members prepare in case power goes out. You know, this was a resident whose family lives out of town and out of state, and they were concerned. And by then, it's kind of late once the snow is already flying and the power is off. So there are, you know, some steps to help people plan ahead of time.
Yeah, we can put that in the newsletter around November or so.
Do it coming off of these storms, because
right.
by the time people get this newsletter in May, we assume we'll be fine. And then do it again for, you know, September, October. We can refresh it again for January, February. Just good information to have.
I just have something I just want to pass out. Not to read it now, it's too much to read, but it's some new thoughts on what people are looking for out of senior centers. It was in the Globe, I don't know if anybody saw it.
No.
And basically what we should call them, a lot of people want to get rid of them as seniors.
Senior center, yeah.
And then there's others say, well, what's wrong with that? We are seniors.
Right.
So, and the way it got approved in Peabody, I think it was Peabody they were talking about. They just built a $10 million or something center. Oh no, Salem. Peabody has had a center.
Peabody has a center. Yeah.
Peabody is well known and well liked
mm-hmm.
center.
Mm-hmm.
But Salem just built this building one. I don't think it's quite open yet. But they tied it to the schools, and that way they got, I believe, the seniors to vote for the schools, because it was all in a package,
mm-hmm.
which was an interesting
thought.
Yeah,
sure. That is, isn't it?
So I'm going to give you the original.
Okay.
And be lucky.
Mm-hmm.
I've numbered them because it was a long article. And like I say, if you want to read it over and have any comments next meeting, that would be great.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Joyce. It's terrific.
My daughter-in-law found it. She reads the Globe every
mm-hmm.
Sunday.
Yeah, okay. Center for Active Living.
Yes.
That's good. I heard that too, but some folks say, well, we are seniors, and then others
right.
who
right.
we would like it. So active living.
And the proportions of the population now in various the state, even how many now, or it's 1 in 5 or something
mm-hmm.
like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
which is
exactly.
really quite interesting.
Mm-hmm. It is.
So.
A lot of needs are yet to be addressed.
Anything else? Maybe this is. I have our next meeting as is April 23rd, because the 19th is a holiday and the school is closed
mm-hmm.
at 1:30.
Okay.
And make the motion to adjourn at 1:32.
Second that.